We found actual genes that play a role in OCD. OCD is Obsessive Compulsive Disorder. And then usually people have specific actions that we call compulsions to relieve that anxiety.
I think OCD is a hidden disorder, but it's really common. So it's around 2.5 to 3%, roughly around as common as diabetes. And it can be incredibly impactful to the point that the World Health Organization rated it as one of the top 10 disabilities in the world.
This study, we combined genetic data from over 50,000 patients and 2 million people with no OCD. We looked at millions of genetic variants, compared whether some of them are more frequent maybe in patients with OCD. And then we found 30 regions on the DNA that are associated with OCD risk. So we can link them. And in these regions, there's around 250 genes that we can link to OCD. We found really large sharing with anxiety disorders, depression, and also with anorexia nervosa. There's a lot of overlap in the genes that cause these different mental health conditions. But it doesn't mean when you have a specific gene variant that you will definitely develop OCD.
I think it's a really significant finding because in terms of treatment for OCD, even though there's reasonable treatment response and efficacy rates, we have stalled and we really need to be looking at other areas. And what this research kind of suggests is that we can be more proactive rather than reactive and actually start looking at who is more likely.
In the future, we hope that if you can put this all together and you have all the genetic information, that if you combine them all, that we can then predict OCD risk more reliably. And of course, the genetic findings, they're exciting, but I really hope that people know these are real conditions, that if you suffer from OCD, it's not your fault. So I really hope that we can now, when we have this list of genes that are linked to OCD, that we can develop more effective treatments.